Shot a hair cue. My shot a hair cue. My shot a hair cute way. My shot a hair cute way.
Hey guys, so today a lot of people have been asking me if I can do a natural hair journey and all that good stuff. The reason why I've been lagging so much is because this is like the most embarrassing video I could ever put out, like ever. Like, this is going back from when I was 12, and 12-year-old Tati is not cute. Now, if you see me looking down, I'm looking at my computer. So, if you want to know, my computer has a bunch of stickers on it. These are two concert tickets from when I was 12 and I went to see Chris Brown, and then this year when I saw Chris Brown. So, get to the first picture, and I'll explain through every picture what I was doing and why did I decide to do that. So, the first picture we have... Now, if any of you guys in my comments decide to say, oh my god, you still look the same, I'm gonna fight you. Like, I'm gonna be so hot, because this is not okay. But when I was little, I used to get perms all the time because I used to live in Texas, and perms were the thing. Like, you always had a perm. It's just something that you do. It's not bad, it's not good. I never really had like it didn't break off like other people had experience where their hair would break off with perms. Mine didn't, but it still looks gross, but it was pretty thick. I tend to wear bows, all sorts of types of bows, so many, and side ponytails, and that was for sure my hairstyle. I thought I was the cutest girl up in that school. Ooh, the next. So, this is when I got my hair cut from one of the hairstylists. And I guess I was feeling myself that day. And I was like, you know what, let's take a picture and let's put on eyeliner? Mascara? I don't really know what makeup this is. I don't want to know. It's still short and it's kind of thick. My edges look laid. I mean, I've never been like a non-edges laid person. That never changed. This is jokes. Wow. So this picture, I told my mom, I was like, I'm gonna go natural and that's it. Cause I remember I went to this basketball game and I saw this girl with curly hair and I was like, oh my god, I want my hair like that. Like, why can't my hair be like that? Like, why is it straightened all the time? So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna try to get my curls back. So I went to the shower and I got a whole bunch of mousse. Whole lot of, don't do that. Racked up, put in my hair, and my hair was dripping. And obviously this is a fail. This is a for sure fail. And maybe it lasted for 2 minutes and I was like, no, I'm done. I'm going back straight. That seriously. So this is when I now moved to California and my hair is obviously straight. It's curled, but I haven't had my hair permed in a good 4 months now. When we moved, we weren't really worried about getting my hair permed. It was more like, okay, we're moving. So maybe we should worry about that. So this one, I decided I want to try a braid out. The braid out looked terrible, so I put in a bun. And now this is like me experimenting. When I went to school in 9th grade, they told me that I have to take swim to graduate. So I'm like, oh, okay, I'll take swim. Took swim. That is the worst thing to do for your hair. I had to get in that water every day with that chlorine. You know I can't straighten my hair every day because I have to get back in the water. So this is when like my transitioning phase started. It wasn't more like a, oh yes, I want to transition. It was more like a forced transition, which I'm actually proud that happened. This picture. So now I'm kind of experimenting with my hair, trying to see, okay, maybe I should wearing a blowout, maybe I should wear a braid out, maybe I should twist it, maybe I don't know what I should do, but I'm trying to figure out my hair a little bit. This picture here, I'm guessing this is a twist out and I was trying to figure out. What I used to do was, during my transitioning phase, is I would twist my hair and then I would take straws and roll it up like it's like a flexi rod, because I was cheap. And I'll roll it up, tie it, and wake up in the morning, untie it, and it'll work the same. And that was my flexi rod straw twist out. Yeah.
Ooh. Oh girl, no.
I'm not even looking at my hair no more.
Do you see my eyebrows?
So that's a no. I'm just gonna skip. That's a no. This next picture, I would always, actually this is during swim. I know this is a TMI, but I would fake my period because my teacher was a man. And did he care? Did he know? Who knows? He didn't want to know. So this is the time I would tell him that, and I would straighten my hair and curl it and put a beanie over it, knowing freaking well that our school does not allow hats. And if you got a hat, they just snatch, snatch, snatch. I can't get snatched. I don't like getting snatched. I don't like getting my hat snatched. I don't like getting my hair snatched. I don't like getting my edges snatched. Nothing like that. But I guess I didn't care during these times. So this time I'm trying low buns, slicking down my hair, you know, opening the door to edges. Now I wasn't like doing my little swoops and all of that, but I was, you know, slicking them down, you know, making sure get out the house, look slick, done, cute, bam. So you know how to make sure to do that. Wearing buns now. I think I was still transitioning. I think I was not straightening my hair at this time. Next one. So my next hairstyle I would currently do is I would wear my hair in a bun. It would be straight dripping, like of wet, it would be straight like watery, like it would be really soaking. Like I would literally be at the movies like going like this because my hair is dripping. And I'll put it in a bun, the back part looking my edges kind of laid though, so I'll give me a 2.5 for that, because the rest just look like a zero. This is the day I chopped off my hair. This is my big okay, this is my big chop. I think this was 2014 January 12th. How do I remember this? This is wow. It was 2 in the morning. Yeah. My friend's telling me, just cut it off, just cut it off. Like, why is it still on your head? Just cut it off. I'm like, you know what? I'm not a little girl, so I'm gonna sit there and I'm gonna cut off my hair. Don't tell me what to do. So I took the scissors, you know, some blunt scissors, not hair clippers. I'm not smart, no. So I took it, I was like, snap, 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 just like that, like just going in. And then I noticed like 2 seconds later that I'm bald headed. So this is a picture of when I, that was a mistake. That was my big chop. Obviously it went well, but don't cut your hair with non-clippers, like regular, like don't do that. Don't do that. This picture, I woke up in the morning, that was the next day, and I was trying to figure out how can I like look cute, because I gotta go to school the next day. How am I gonna just, my hair is not gonna grow back in 2.5 seconds. I didn't know what box braids were. I didn't know what Senegalese twists were. I wish I knew what those were, because I had to go to school like this. So this is my hair I was trying. This day I decided to do a twist out, because I never done it, on my now newly cut bald headed head. Great. So I decided to do a twist out, but did I leave it out? No. I put it back up in a puff. Yeah, and I thought I was popping. I got my little sun shades on. Do I even have those? No, I don't. Put my little sun shades on. I'm looking cute, you know, popping. Nobody ain't gonna tell me nothing. My hair coils popping, edges lay, eyebrows. No skipping. Oh, this is when my hair started growing and it started stopping right here, which I'm like kind of cool about, because now it like it,
and stops over, like, past the polos on. That's cool.
That's when I start pulling. I was like, yeah, I got inches, man. I got inches. Girl's about to get the hair problem with my hair grow wild. Nobody can't tell me nothing. About to pull your dude. About to pull your dude. Twist that afro. Twist that afro. Okay, I'm sorry. I think I really have ADHD. I can't do this no more. Like, I can't pay attention no more. I'm tired of looking at these photos. Like, why did I have to look like this?
It was Halloween, the next Halloween, and I was Mickey Mouse or Minnie Mouse on a. I was Minnie Mouse on a budget. That's what I was. I was exactly that. No ears, just the bow that I had since kindergarten. Who gonna tell me I can't wear that? Who gonna tell me I can't do it? Please tell me I can't do it. Exactly.
Finally, I'm seeing a decent picture. Like, this is what I think I'm most evolving, you know, looking better, getting my edges to grow back. Edges growing back, hair getting longer, buzz coming closer.
Now tell me my edges wasn't laid in this picture. Tell me my edges wasn't laid. Girl, my man.
Next one, this was my 16th birthday. I thought it was super cute. And I think this is a cornrow out. This is a cornrow out for sure. In this picture, I got Senegalese twists for the summer because I didn't want to deal with my hair. And so I got those in my head and I look like a bad.
Oh, but I'm gonna let y'all finish it, but I look bad. So, yeah.
This one look good! I look like a model.
I think now we look the same, like. She look better though. She alright. That's okay. Don't joke. But my hair growing. I think this was a regular braid out. This is homecoming. I straightened my hair for homecoming because I haven't straightened my hair in a while. So I just straightened my hair for homecoming and girl, I look bad, honey.
That's how I look.
Here is just a wash and go. This is when I really started getting comfortable with my hair and getting comfortable with myself and started loving my hair myself and all of that good stuff. This is when I cut bangs into my hair and kind of layered my hair so it could be like one of those cute afros. So that's what it was. This is when I started using the cornrow, like cornrow hairstyle, and that's when I filmed it that day. And
bad, like tell me I wasn't bad, girl.
And this is really recent, and me with my hair all out and curly, I'm done with the hair journey. Wow. What I learned about this journey? It was hard, it was fun, and I kind of learned who I was for myself. Like, I learned who I am and what I like to do and what type of people I like to hang out with and what I want to be, what I want to come off to people. So I also learned myself and my hair. So, and my hair's always been a big deal to me, so if I change my hair 24/7, that's just me. But I guess the tips I can say is don't become a product junkie. You don't need that many products. If you have a natural hair journey and you're cutting off your hair, take a whole crap load of photos, because like I did, where you can look back on them and be like, wow, I really went somewhere, I really came somewhere. And my last tip, girl, you gotta love yourself. You gotta love yourself in all ways, because if you don't love yourself, then you won't be able to really grow out your hair healthy. You're gonna start comparing your hair to other people. And I'm not gonna lie, I compared my hair to Beyonce. I did a couple times. But you know, I noticed, you know, I'm not Beyonce, but I'm her daughter. So I'm gonna just be as bad as her. So the last tip is be as bad as Beyonce's daughter. Well, no. Be as bad as Beyonce, but I'm her daughter. That's what it was.
So I want to thank you guys for watching. That was my natural hair tutorial, my natural hair journey. And now y'all just know a whole lot more than a lot of people actually know about me and pictures wise. Oh, see you later. See you later, Spotica.